He cannot say that. If anybody said that, he's not Muslim. Because no Muslim can say such things. There is some people said that, but they are not Muslims. But if somebody believe in that, that he's, this is not Muslims. But some people said, he's everywhere, but he means his knowledge everywhere. They don't mean himself. So some people ignorant, they might say, Allah is everywhere, but out of ignorance, you should teach them, they should not use this term. They should use Allah's knowledge is everywhere. Allah know everywhere. Allah know everything. But Allah himself above his throne, above his heavens, subhan. And Allah, he not made from nur. One of Allah's attributes that his face has nur, has lights. And he has hijab. And this hijab is made of nur. Hijab, it is like a partition or a veil between him and his creation. And this partition or this veil is from lights. Because the lights of his face, subhanahu wa ta'ala, if this partition or this veil does not exist, this light could burn everything in front of him. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the authentic hadith. So the nur is one of his attributes and one of his names. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is still alive. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is in his grave and he has a special life in his grave. But he's not alive in a sense of alive like us. Otherwise, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he's alive like us, the Sahaba should not pray funeral prayer on him, because this only on dead people. On dead people. What do Jews mean when they say someone is anti-Semite? I don't know exactly. They mean if somebody hates them. That's what he means, I believe. Or he doesn't like the Jews. Or he doesn't believe they are being favored upon others. We are, as Muslims, we believe that the Jewish been favored upon all other nations. We believe that. Allah said that in the Quran. We don't need anybody to tell us that. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he did not favor you upon other because your color or your length or because your names or your tribes or no, because you are a good Muslim, a good worshiper. And whenever you leave this, you go to the lowest of the lowest, as Allah said in the Quran. So when the Jewish broke their promises with Allah and they disbelieve in Allah and they killed his messengers and his prophets, and they deny his messages, and they do not accept Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he didn't send them, and it's clear in their books that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the prophet, they became the worst. And therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cursed them after that. And Allah punished them after that. So we don't believe that anybody has a special relationship with Allah in a sense or in a way, make him special, so he will not be punished or he will not be asked about his mistakes. She said, I was pregnant and a woman told me, pray two rak'ahs for the sake of Allah, read Surah Yasin and says, oh Allah, make him a boy, a baby boy, make it a baby boy and I will call him Muhammad. And when I delivered the boy, I got a baby boy, but my husband gave him another name. Is this nadr I was supposed to fulfill a promise? هذه الأخت تسأل تقول كنت حامل بابني قالت لي امرأة إذا صليت ركعتين لوجه الله وقرأت منهما سورة ياسين وقلت اللهم اجعل ما في بطني ذكرا وأسميه محمدا وعندما وضعته كان ولدا ولكن زوجي سماه اسما آخر، فهل يعتبر نذر ولم أوفي به أو أنه دعاء ولا شيء علي؟ والله هذا يعتبر بنيتك يا أختي، إن كنت نذرت أن تسميه محمد فلا يشترط أن تقولي نذرت، نذرت لا تشترط، لأن العبرة بالمعاني لا بالمباني، العبرة بالحقائق لا بالألفاظ. فإذا كان أنت نيتك أنك نذرت أن تسمي هذا الولد محمد فهذا نذر قد أخلفتيه، يجب عليك كفارة النذر، وهي ككفارة اليمين إطعام 10 مساكين أو كسوتهم تطعمين 10 مساكين طعمة واحدة أو تكسينهم. فإن لم يكن لديك مال للإطعام أو للكسوة فتصومي 3 أيام. ثم لا يشرع ما فعلت من أن تصلي ركعتين وتقرأ سورة ياسين، هذه منها ليس لها أصل في سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور ما أحدث. I tell the sisters it based on her intention. If her intention that she promised, if she got a baby boy, she will call him Muhammad, and she broke her promise, she has to make the kafara of nadr, which is similar to the kafara if you swear and you didn't fulfill your swearing. If you swear and you didn't fulfill your swearing, or you promised Allah something and you broke your promise with him, there is kafara, something to do it in order to ask Allah to forgive your sins, which is to give 10 poor people 10 meals. Or, let me put it in the right English, to give 10 meals for the sake of Allah. Full meals, dinner or lunch. Like rice, chicken, salad even, full meal. If you can fulfill it with complete meals, that would be good. You can give it to one person, to 10 person, to 2 persons, up to you. In one time, in 10 days, it's up to you. Or to give clothes for 10 people, or 10 clothes. And clothes is shirt and pants, or one thobe. And if you couldn't, you don't have money to do one of these, you fast 3 days. But it's not from the sunnah, not from the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He told us to do such things, to read Surah Yasin and 2 rak'ah and things like that. And the best thing to do what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, and the worst thing to do what's not in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sunnah. Does anybody has any more questions? Tafadhal. Ismail alayhi salam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that he is the father of the Arab, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the most knowledgeable person, and he told us that he is the father of the Arab, and his Arabic language in some narrations be taught through Jibreel. The Arabic language exists before Ismail, and the Arab nations exist before Ismail. But Ismail alayhi salam, his Arabic was the best Arabic ever exist. It was perfect. It's different a little bit from the people of Jurhum in that time he was raised with. Then it's been adopted after him, this language, which is came with different in some vocabularies and in forms and terms. It changed then, it's different than the Arab people, but it's the same language, alphabet and everything, pronunciations,